Hi and welcome to Dan Makes Things. My name is Dan and in the last video I walked through an introduction to the Viam platform, which enables faster development of robots and smart machines by providing easy configuration and prototyping, simple sharing of functionality, and a community to support any issues. In this video I want to show you how I'm leveraging the platform in my robotics build to make it easier to work with and learn, and how you can do the same with yours for free. This video is sponsored by Viam, but I want to be clear that I approached them to propose a partnership because I believe their software is a solid approach to leveling up my project and hopefully other projects in the future. Let's take a look. We covered modules briefly in the last video, but today I want to deep dive into why Viam modules are useful, how they're used, and then look at creating our own. Let's talk about the two main elements you would configure to build a robot. Components are digital representations of the physical components of the device. A few simple examples of this would be motors or servos, sensors, the board that controls your machine, such as the Raspberry Pi. A more abstract example of a component would be the base, which represents the physical structure of the machine, containing all the components listed above. Services, on the other hand, don't have a physical counterpart and represent code or behaviors that can be executed using input from components or enhancing the output of components. For example, a text-to-speech generator or even a large language model. Following so far? Let's take a look at some more terms. Custom components and services can be created to extend the functionality of the component or service type. Because they're built on the Viam API, they have common methods and API endpoints we can leverage. We call these modular resources. For example, every servo component available in Viam will have the method move and will take an angle as the argument, but the implementation or additional functionality may be different. To share these resources with other users of the platform, we create modules, like a package of code, containing one or more of these resources. By creating a module, the author of that code can manage changes and distribute them easily. It would be amazing if there could be a finite list of resources that we could use to build every robot conceivable, but in reality, there are so many options that it isn't feasible for the Viam team to do alone. But there's good news. The Viam Modular Registry allows anyone working with the platform to build their own modules and share them with the rest of the community, completely free of charge. Because each component and service uses a common API framework, we can even use modules built in multiple languages and have them all work together. One of the things that makes modules so powerful is that they're completely self-contained. When you opt to install a module, a script within the package defines which dependencies need to be installed, and Viam will install them and track the status of the module automatically. So if a module is updated in future, you can choose to install the latest version or set Viam to automatically keep that module up to date. This means that updates and stability issues in modules can be resolved and tracked easily. It also means that as someone who uses a module, we don't need to worry about changes to the code and syncing code from other sources. We just set the version we want and Viam does the rest. But how do we use the module once it's installed? There are a few ways we can interact with modules. Some resources have their own native UI. This means you can jump into the control tab on app.viam.com for your robot and interact directly with the resource there. A good example would be the servo components, where you can set the position directly via the web browser or mobile app. If the native UI isn't enough, you can also create your own app, for example using Flutter, and control your robot with custom buttons and actions. Alternatively, you can also write code to connect to and consume the resource. Some modules in the registry include examples in the README or a client Python file, which shows the basic functionality and can be executed by downloading the file and connecting to your robot. The connection works by defining these environment variables, which are unique to your robot. You can set them in your bash RC file or temporarily to test. In addition, Viam's secure authorization allows us to use these variables to control a robot from anywhere, as long as we have the correct API key, ID, and address. When you start using the example code, you can see that there is a list of resources that can be retrieved and output to the log. This shows which resources have been installed on the robot and what their names are. You can then use this command to access the resource and call methods on the instance of that resource to interact with any of the functionality you need to. This is much more powerful than using the UI, because it means you can chain together requests from multiple modules and build some complex and really interesting behaviors. You can also do something similar between modules by referencing a module in another module's configuration as a dependency. This then allows you to consume module A in module B. One of the challenges to the code examples I've just shown is that you need to explicitly reference the resource that you're looking to consume. For a lot of uses, this is fine, but sometimes you might not want that hard dependency between modules. An example of this is in my project, where we rely heavily on the publisher-subscriber design pattern to enable modular and optional behaviors to be carried out as part of the operation of the robot. With PubSub, many modules can subscribe to a published event and choose whether to react to it and what to do. The publisher doesn't care whether any subscribers are listening, it just publishes and moves on with its day. It's also useful if there needs to be more than one response from a method call or multiple responses that are delayed by fixed time periods, as is the case for the animation scripts in my project. But previously there was an issue. PyPubSub, which I use in my project to this point, can only send messages within its own running Python process. But because Viam modules take advantage of being able to run multiple Python processes at once, each module can't see any of the others using that architecture. To manage these use cases, I collaborated with the Viam team to create a new MQTT broker module. MQTT is a lightweight machine-to-machine network protocol for message queuing. It's designed for connections with remote locations that have devices with resource constraints or limited network bandwidth, such as the Internet of Things. It utilizes a broker that queues and distributes published messages to any subscribers quickly and with a robust architecture that can not only bridge the gap between Python processes, but also between devices. The Viam MQTT broker module can be installed on the robot and configured, either to connect to a local or remote MQTT instance, or even configured to create an MQTT instance specifically for its own use. Then, every module that would like to publish to a topic can do so, and any module that needs to subscribe just needs to include that same MQTT service as a dependency and subscribe to the same topic. This means that module-to-module communication is possible without any need to define a long list of dependencies that change depending on the evolving functionality of the robot. Just give the module access to the MQTT service and watch it go. Now, because of the wide range of options for inter-module communication available, we get to choose which is best for our use case. I generally say that native UI interaction is best for quick tests and adjustments, and building a custom app is best for when you need bespoke controls that aren't available out of the box. When using scripts, you have three options: locally executed, best for low latency applications, for example, self-balancing robots; remotely executed, best when utilizing a more powerful machine or for quick iteration during development; and cloud compute, best for leveraging the higher specs for specialized tasks such as machine learning. You can also have a module consume another module directly when the dependencies are known, fixed, or need synchronous communication, or via the MQTT broker when that isn't the case, or if you need to use topics and events for another use case. To build on the functionality already in place, I created a few modules that work for my project and can be installed on others easily. The longer term goal is to move all of my Python modules into Viam modular resources and have a single script referencing those to manage the behavior. For the purposes of this video, I have three that I want to cover: animation, servo, and serial. In the current project, the animation module can take a name of an animation as input. It then loads the corresponding JSON file, which contains a list of instructions. These can be servo positions, LED commands, audio output, even other animation scripts. In the case of servos, the animation module publishes to the servo send topic, requesting that each specific servo moves. Each servo is a separate component, defined in the config tab, and each has their own topic to subscribe to, as the topic includes the identifier of that servo. This way, each can be published to individually. The servo module then takes the request, applies some safety considerations, and then requests the servo to move. For safety, I wanted to ensure that the servos would never be asked to move past their physical range, as this could damage the robot. So I designed my servo module to work with a defined range and then pass the module a percentage of that range as an argument, rather than an angle. Most of the servos are connected to an Arduino microcontroller that manages the actual movement and position. This is connected via serial to the Raspberry Pi. Because of this, the servo module publishes an event to a serial module, which manages that connection to the Arduino and sends the instructions. The modular nature of the project means that if I wanted to remove the head and disconnect the servos, or even attach it to a different base, maybe one with wheels, the software would allow me to do that, and the animations would adjust accordingly by ignoring any instructions for the servos that aren't currently connected. Let's give it a test. You can see here we have an example script that will accept the name of an animation as input and publish it to the animation topic. So all I need to do is run this, pass in one of the animation JSON file names, such as lookup. Once I hit return, the animation script receives the topic, passes the action to any relevant servos, then onto the serial service, and finally onto the Arduino to move the servos. In future, I could also add predefined commands for the Arduino, so I could send the command stand over serial and have the Arduino use the already existing inverse kinematics and inertial measurement software to make the robot stand without the need for individual servo positions coming from the Raspberry Pi. Viam makes it easy to create a module yourself with the module generator. This script creates a template based on your input to give you a great starting point to begin building. Take a look at the link in the description for more information. Once you have your module created, you can jump in and start adding the specific functionality you want to include. To test your module, add it locally, then create the component or service and start to test. If you need to install it on a remote device because you're working with a specific software or hardware architecture, you can use a tool like Mutagen to sync your local code with your remote device. Take a look at the guide linked in the description for more information. So you've created a module and it's ready to share. Now you can jump into the terminal and publish it to the registry. This will make your module available on the registry for others to use. And if you make further changes, you can easily publish a new version once you've tested it locally and you're ready to publish again. So far, we've created modules and then connected to those modules with scripts in order to run them from the terminal. But what if you want to have a script run when the Viam server starts? That's where processes come in. Processes allow you to specify a script and have it execute and restart with the Viam server. Think of this as your main PY file in Python. Then you can connect to the components, services, modules, and any other resources and define the behavior you'd like your robot to exhibit. This is great for defining code to run as soon as you start the robot. We've been through a lot in this video, but don't worry, the resources are there to help you get started and work your way through this process. You can use the AI assistant to ask questions about anything Viam related, read the guides and example tutorials, join the Viam Discord community, and post in the Ask Us forum to discuss your projects and questions. I'm looking forward to migrating my existing work into Viam, and I'm really excited to see what kind of functionality the community publishes to the registry in future. If you'd like to get started, go to app.viam.com and create your first robot. Thanks for watching.